Hello everyone, this is Sumita Gupta. Welcome you all for my next tutorial of Cisco Packet Tracer. So today we will learn traffic congestion using Cisco Packet Tracer. So first of all, we have to start the Cisco Packet Tracer. Okay, in Cisco Packet Tracer, first of all, file and new. Okay, now we have to make a network. So for that, I'm taking one switch. Then PCs take around 4 PCs, PC1, PC2, PC3, PC4, and one server. Okay, now this is for connecting wires. Take this one and connect all the PCs to this switch like this. Fast Ethernet 1, then Fast Ethernet 2, then Fast Ethernet 3, Fast Ethernet 4, okay, Fast Ethernet 5. Okay, after some time, these all will be green. Means the connection will be completed. So it will take around 30-40 seconds. So it becomes the green. After some time, these all becomes the green. Okay, yes. So this is, first of all, the step one is completed. This our network is completed. Now next is to define the IP addresses. So click on PC, then click on desktop IP configuration. Suppose I am taking the series 192.168.10.1. okay, so I am taking the series 10.1, then next is I am taking 10.2. Desktop IP configuration 192.168.10.2. Okay, now next for same, now next PC, I am giving it 10.3. For next PC, I am giving it 10.4. Okay, so these all about the about the PCs. Now for server, I'm giving a different address. Desktop IP configuration, I'm giving it 10.250. okay, so in this way we have given the IP addresses to everyone, means every PCs and server. Now all are green, these connections are completed. First step, second step, IP addresses completed. The third step is we have to check the connectivity, whether it is right or wrong. So check this and pass this message and check with the simulation, or you can say delete this one first of all. Check the simulation like this. Now see here, the status is successful. Means suppose I am giving from 1 to 3, so 1 to 3 successful. Okay, from 2 to 3 successful. So in this way we have checked the connectivity. First we have designed the network, second we have given the IP addresses, third we have checked the connectivity. Now the next step is we want to define this server. We want to make this web server. So click on the server and click on the IP configuration, no, not like that, services. Click on services and check HTTP should be on and HTTPS should be on. Okay, again listen, click on server and click on services. These two should be on, and click on the index.html and you can add it here. Okay, you can add it means you can delete, and you can type your message also. So here it is, welcome to Cisco Packet Tracer. So you can write like welcome to simulation of traffic congestion. Like this, you can type anything, simulation of fabric condition. So we have defined like this, say, then it will be say override. So you click on yes, override. Okay, cross it. Okay, again you can check in this whether it was saved or not. It is saved. Now you can check whether it's from the web server or not. So click on any PC, click on web browser, and type the server address 192.168.2.250 and go. It will take some time, but after some time it will be, the message will be here. Request timeout, so again I will try. It's taking some time. Again I will try web browser 10.2. Okay, so now message is welcome to simulation of traffic condition. You can change this heading also, Cisco packet tracing. How? See, click on this server, index, edit. So in Cisco packet tracer, I can write experiment 7, or I can write tutorial 7. Cisco packet tracer. Cisco packet tracer. Okay, now save it. Yes. Now I'm checking from the another PC. PC 2, web browser. Click on web browser. Now type the IP address of the server 250. So now see the heading is changed. Tutorial 7 Cisco packet trace. Okay. So now remember, step 1 was network, step 2 was IP address, step 3 was checking the connectivity, step 4 was the to make the server to web server and check from any of the host PC. Now next step is we have to check the protocols of HTTP. Okay. For that, click on any PC. Suppose I'm clicking on one PC and click on traffic generator. In traffic generator, click on HTTP. In HTTP, what is destination address? Is definitely a server address. Okay, and source address, I have clicked PC number 1. So PC number 1's IP address was 192.168.10.1 and the port address 1050 and size we can take 64. Okay, and take periodic and interval take 2 seconds. Okay, send. For simplicity, you can write the IP address here so that you can't forget which PC I have given the which IP address. So I can write here 192.168.10.1. So you can remember the IP address of each PC like this 192.168.10.2. Here it was 10.3, 192.168.10.3. Just for simplicity, you can understand, and you can give any name also. Name like AMS PC 1, PC 2, PC 3, PC 4. So any name you can give. Okay. So here also 192.168.10.250. Now what next for this PC is done. Now for PC number 2, needs after 01. So click on this traffic generator, same process, HTTP, destination IP address is server IP address 250, and now source IP address is now 10.2. okay, the starting port address is fixed, that is 1050. Size you can change. Okay, periodic interval we are taking 2 seconds, you can take different values. In this way, for all PC we will do traffic generator, HTTP, destination IP address, that is server address, source IP address, now it will be 3. Okay, starting port address 1050, periodic interval of 2 seconds, send. Same way we'll do for PC number 4. In PC number 4, traffic generator, HTTP, destination IP address 250. It is PC number 4, it should be 4. Okay, so in this way, we'll do for each PC, whatever we are using. Okay, now interval is 2 seconds. Set. Okay, so in this way, we have used the traffic generator. Remember, click on the PC, click on traffic generator. In traffic generator, you are defining the HTTP protocols. Okay, you are defining the HTTP protocol means traffic congestion using the HTTP protocol. Now you can start the simulation. Click on here, simulation. You can capture also. So click on this. So now simulation start. Okay, and all the information you are getting here. Everyone message passing through switch. Switch 0 to PC 1. Switch 0 to PC 0. Okay, and what you can do? You can check this event list also. Window list, PDU list window, all the information here. See here, when you click on the real-time simulation here, this type is mentioned, DTP, STP, TCP. So you can check once after clicking on traffic generator whether we have given everything is correct or not. Because last time I forgot to type 64, so I got the error. So I changed that. Now it is okay. Okay. So what I am doing, I am reset the simulation. I am again starting it. And by clicking on this square, you can check the information. Means the model information, outbound details. So here it is, the details are coming here. The HTTP process signs of the configuration BPDU. The device encapsulates so PDU. So in this way, you will get all the details here. Click on this packet and you will get the information of the in layers, out layers like this. The pink color indicates that it receives the frame. So fast Ethernet 0 receives the frame. Now next here, Ethernet receives the frame. So pink color means it is showing that the communication is done. The purple is running in application. The purple one is running application. The pink one is means this is done. And remember, it can change to STP. It will show TCP. Okay. So again, I'm resetting the application. See here, now it is showing DTP. Then STP. So it will change like this. So in this way, you can get the all the information. So we have done simulation of traffic congestion using Cisco Packet Tracer. So if you like it, please like and share. If you have any doubt, you can type in comment box. Thank you. God bless.